Welcome to STEM class! Last week we looked at how computers send images by sending one pixel at a time. How do you think computers send letters? We can't stick a letter in a wire. Electrical wires can only do one thing, and that's carry electricity. They're either carrying electricity or not carrying electricity. But how could we turn that electricity into a message? We can use different patterns of electricity being either on or off to mean different things. In this circuit, we can tell when the electricity is running through the wire because the light will turn on. We convert these ons and offs into numbers that can then mean anything we want. How can we convert on and off into numbers? Well, let's write on as a 1 and off as a 0. This is called binary because there are only two things our signal can be, either on or off. Then we can use different sequences of on or off, 1 or 0, to encode our data in a form the computer can understand. If you want to learn exactly how binary numbers work, I put a link down in the description. For example, in the standard UTF-8 encoding for letters, the letter D is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. O is 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. And G is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. Hey, now we spelled dog. But the computer can use these same sequences to mean a number, like for math or counting or time. These zeros and ones might also not mean letters or numbers. They might be the amount of red, green, and blue in a pixel in an image. So just by turning on and off electricity in certain patterns, we can send all kinds of information. Now, computers send it much faster than I was just saying. They can send millions of these signals every second. It's up to the people making the code and circuits in these computers to help the computer know how to decode zeros and ones into numbers, letters, sounds, pixels, or whatever else we want to send. Whenever a computer is sending a letter, it's really turning electricity on and off in a certain pattern that the computer recognizes as that letter. For example, if you push a letter key on the keyboard sends an electrical signal about that letter to the motherboard. Last week, you all decoded my penguin pixel art. This week, you're going to encode and decode some text. Representing something in a different way is called encoding. Changing something to be easy for people to understand is decoding. Turn to your STEM packet on page 8. There's a nice code there and a secret message that I wrote for you. So the first thing to do is decode the message using this code. It is a simple code. It just has a number for each letter. So that should be no problem for you. But then I want you to make your own code down here where you have something representing each letter. It could be a symbol or a color or a little drawing. You just need a different symbol for each letter. Then encode a secret message here and see if someone else can decode it. You can make your code on paper and show it to someone. Or if it's easier, you can make a code in Google Docs and then share it with a friend so they can try and decode it. I hope you stay safe, have fun, and keep decoding.